Hello friends, welcome to anujindal.in. So in today's lecture, I am going to discuss with you the syllabus of cost accounting for the purpose of SEBI Grade A examination. So the notification for SEBI Grade examination is about to come. So in today's video, I will discuss the syllabus of costing in detail. So basically, the objective of this video is that you can cover the syllabus of costing on your own by studying the topics from either Google or from textbooks. Okay, so as you know, there are six subjects in the SEBI grade examination: cost accounting, companies act, commerce and accountancy, economics, finance and management. So in today's lecture, we will discuss the topics of cost accounting in detail. So let's start. So this is the syllabus of cost accounting. If you look at the notification, last year notification of SEBI grade examination, this is the syllabus given, but this is very broad based. Okay, so I will discuss that what you need to study in each of these topics. Okay, so the first topic is objectives of cost and management accounting, introduction to cost accounting, management accounting, their objectives and scope, right? Then methods of costing. There are various methods of costing like unit costing, job costing, batch costing, and many other methods. Then cost control. So under cost control, you have standard costing, marginal costing. You also have absorption costing. So some topics are missing in the sense are not explicitly given in the syllabus, but you have to cover them because you cannot study marginal costing without absorption costing, right? Then there is CVP analysis. Then budget and budgetary control. Then finally, lean system and innovation. So under this, there are various techniques and various innovative practices adopted by companies all over the world, like just in time, Kaizen, 5S, total productive maintenance, okay, Six Sigma, and majority of these techniques have come from Japan. So now let us discuss these topics one by one in detail. So firstly, we will discuss what is the overview of management accounting. Okay, so what you need to study under management accounting. So first of all, meaning, very, very important. Then what are the features or characteristics of management accounting? Okay, because management accounting basically is future oriented and it helps the managers in taking decisions. Then what is the scope? Okay, then functions or objectives. What are the different objectives of management accounting? Okay, so management accounting is not mandatory, it is optional. So why do companies go for management accounting? That will be covered under the objective part. Then what is the difference between financial accounting, cost accounting and management accounting? So these are the three different fields of study. So you need to know the basic differences between all the three. And then finally, what are the limitations of management accounting? Okay, so one of the limitations is that management accounting is expensive to install. Okay, now next is cost accounting, overview of cost accounting. So under that, you need to study first of all the meaning of cost accounting, then what are the objectives and functions. So like some of the objectives are cost control, cost reduction. Then what is the scope? Then difference between financial accounting and cost accounting, very, very important. What is the difference between these two? Then there are various other important concepts like cost. What is the meaning of cost? Different types of cost like expired cost, unexpired cost. What is a cost center? Okay, what is a cost unit? Cost unit, this is very, very important again. Then cost object. Then what are the elements of cost, like direct cost, indirect cost, variable cost, fixed cost, you have a prime cost. Okay, so all these concepts and the formulas you need to study. Then what is a cost sheet? What is the format of cost sheet? How does a cost sheet look like? What are the elements? Okay, then finally, advantages and disadvantages of cost accounting. So these are the various topics you need to study under the introduction part of cost accounting, right? Now next is methods of costing. So basically you need to study these six methods of costing. Number one is unit costing. Unit costing is also called output costing. So you need to study the meaning and what is the purpose of unit costing. Okay, and in which industries is unit costing followed. Okay, you need to know the industries under which unit costing is being followed. Then job costing. Next method is job costing. So under job costing, again you need to know the meaning of job costing. What are the features, objectives? Okay, what are the objectives? And then costing procedure. So there is a three-step procedure under job costing. So that you need to study. And again, in which industries is job costing being practiced? That you need to study. Then batch costing. So batch costing, a very important concept in batch costing which you need to study is economic batch quantity. It is like EOQ. EOQ is economic order quantity, and this is EBQ, economic batch quantity. Then contract costing. So contract costing is, you can say, an extended version of job costing only. Okay, so you need to know the meaning of contract costing. What are the features, the costing procedure? Then very important, under contracts, this concept of work in progress is very, very important. Okay, so there is a concept called work certified and work uncertified. Okay, so based on this concept, there are certain formulas that you need to remember. Then what is escalation clause? This is also very, very important. Then next is process costing. Okay, so you need to know the meaning of process costing. What is the costing procedure? The difference between process costing and job costing, very, very important. You need to know the difference between all these six methods. Okay, then normal versus abnormal loss. Okay, so normal or abnormal, what is abnormal? Which is beyond normal. Okay, so any loss which is above normal, it will be called abnormal loss. Or you can say that type of loss which is due to some unexpected happening. Okay, that is abnormal loss. Then equivalent production. So there is a formula to calculate equivalent production units. Okay, then internal process profits. What is the meaning of internal process profits? And finally, the difference between joint product, byproduct and co-product. Because what happens in a process, sometimes two or three products are manufactured. So you need to know the difference between joint product, byproduct and co-product. MCQs can be asked from this topic of joint product. Okay, then finally, the last method you need to study is service costing. Okay, so what is service costing? What are the characteristics of service costing? Then very, very important concept, composite cost unit. Okay, what is a composite cost unit? Then costing in certain service sectors like transport, boiler house, canteen and hospitals. So particularly these four service sectors are important from the examination point of view. So you need to study them as well. Now moving on. Next is standard costing. So what is standard costing? So before that, you need to know the limitations of historical costing, because standard costing overcomes the limitations of historical costing. Then uses of standard cost system. So what is the uses or what are the benefits? Okay, then you should also know the meaning of standard cost. What is the meaning of standard cost? Okay, so standard cost and estimated cost, what is the difference between the two? Then difference between standard costing and budgetary control. So budgetary control is a separate topic I will discuss. So you need to know the difference between the two, because these two are related. Okay, then what is the limitations of standard costing, right? And finally, what are the prerequisites in establishing a system of standard costing? So for that, there are four prerequisites. Number one, establishment of cost centers so that responsibility can be assigned. Then classification of accounts. Then there are different types of standards like basic standard, current standard, okay, that you need to study. And then finally, setting standard costs for materials, for labor, for overheads. You need to set the standard cost. Okay, so this all you need to study under standard costing. Now, related to standard costing is variance analysis. So variance analysis is a part of standard costing. So under variance analysis, what you need to study? First of all, the difference between favorable and unfavorable variances. So variance basically means deviation from the actual. Okay. So variance can be favorable for the company or unfavorable for the company. Then controllable versus uncontrollable variance. Okay. Then very, very important, material variance, labor variance and overhead variance. So there are formulas for all the three types of variances. Okay. So, and they have components. So material variance has two components, material price variance and material usage variance. Similarly, labor variance has labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance. So formulas are given. So you need to study the formulas and you need to know how to calculate the various types of variances, because small practical questions can also be asked from this topic. And then finally, overhead variance. Okay. Then disposition of variances. Disposition means final settlement, or how do you settle or how do you show them in the books of accounts. So there are three methods that you need to study. And then finally, there are some control ratios like efficiency ratio, activity ratio, turnover ratio, calendar ratio. So these ratios you also need to study. Okay. Now moving on. Next is marginal costing, which is also called variable costing. Marginal costing is also called variable costing. So first of all, you need to know the difference between product cost and period cost. This is a very basic difference which you should know. Okay. Then for studying variable costing, you should also study absorption costing, because these two are studied together. These two are studied together. Okay. So absorption costing, what is absorption costing? What are the characteristics of absorption costing? Okay, then variable costing and what are the characteristics of variable costing? Okay, then what is the difference between absorption and variable costing? This is very, very important, because these two, absorption and variable costing, are different in the sense that variable manufacturing overheads, the treatment of variable manufacturing overheads is different under absorption and variable costing. Okay. Then difference in profit under absorption and variable costing. So there are three cases. Those three cases you need to study. Then what are the advantages of variable costing and what are the disadvantages of variable costing? So again, this marginal costing topic is very, very important, and you can expect many MCQs from this topic. Okay. Now next is CVP analysis. So again, CVP analysis is a part of marginal costing only. Okay. So in CVP analysis, there are a lot of formulas. So again, you can expect certain practical questions from this topic. Okay. So you need to study contribution margin. What is contribution margin concept? PV ratio, profit volume ratio. Okay. What is break even analysis? Then calculation of break even point in rupees also and in units also, both. You need to know the formula for both. Okay. Then what is angle of incidence? And how does it affect your profits? Okay. Then margin of safety. So again, margin of safety is a concept. So you have to know the formula of margin of safety. Then what is cost and difference point? Okay. So these are the various topics under CVP analysis. And as I told you, there are a lot of formulas. So you need to study all the formulas. Then next is budget and budgetary control. Okay. So budgetary control is a very important technique, you can say. So, and budgets, there are different types of budgets. So these are two topics, you can say. First of all, you need to know the characteristics of budgetary control. What are the characteristics of budgetary control system? Okay. Then what are the objectives? Why this budgetary control is installed in a company? What are the benefits? What are the objectives? Then prerequisites for successful implementation. Then functional budgets. So there are different types of functional budgets, like sales budget. Okay. You have sales budget, you have purchase budget. Okay. Then you have production budget, you have cash budgets. So there are different types of functional budgets. So you need to know the basic information about these budgets. Then what is master budget? Very, very important. So master budget, it is a summary of all the functional budgets. Okay. So all the budgets are prepared in a summarized manner in master budget. Okay. Then difference between fixed and flexible budget. This is also very, very important. Then budget report. What is a budget report? Zero based budgeting. So zero-based budgeting is different from traditional budgeting because under zero-based budgeting, the targets or the budget is set in a refresh manner. So it is different from incremental budgeting. Incremental budgeting में क्या होता है कि previous year के budget में कुछ additional amount add कर देते हैं. But this is not the case in zero-based budgeting. In zero-based budgeting, the budgets are prepared afresh. Okay? And finally, performance budgeting. So performance budgeting में भी certain procedure follow होता है. So वो भी एक important topic है. Now the last topic which you need to cover for cost accounting is lean system and innovation. Okay? So first of all, what is the meaning of lean system? And what are the principles? There are 5 main principles of lean manufacturing that you need to study. Okay. Then different types of waste. So waste are called muda. In Japanese, waste are called muda. So there are 7 types of waste that you need to study. Then what is JIT? Just in time manufacturing. Just in time. Okay. So again, it has come from Japan and basically from Toyota. So most of these techniques have come from Toyota. Okay. So what are the advantages of JIT? What are the disadvantages? Then Kanban. So Kanban again is a Japanese technique. So basically Kanban is a workflow. It is a workflow diagram. So companies have Kanban boards in which they schedule. And basically they schedule and try to eliminate the time which is wasted, okay, in the workflow. So again, very important technique. Then total quality management, and under total quality management, there is a technique called benchmarking. Then Kaizen, you need to study. Kaizen is very, very important. The meaning of Kaizen is continuous improvement. Okay. And under Kaizen, a important topic is Deming wheel. Okay. Then there is this 5S technique. 5S is basically for organizing workspaces. Okay. Organizing the workspaces. So you have this 5S technique. Okay. Then Six Sigma, I hope most of you would be aware. So Six Sigma is concerned with reducing variation. Okay. Reducing variation in production. So there are 2 methods of Six Sigma, DMAIC and DMADV. And then another topic is Lean Six Sigma. So Lean Six Sigma combines 2 concepts, lean manufacturing and Six Sigma. Then there is total productive maintenance. Okay. Total productive maintenance. And there are 8 pillars. There are 8 pillars of total productive maintenance. So basically the objective of total productive maintenance is zero breakdowns or zero failures of machines. Okay. Zero breakdowns in equipments or machines. So there is another topic, overall equipment effectiveness. This is connected with TPM. Then cellular manufacturing or one piece flow production system. Okay. So what is the meaning of cellular manufacturing? Basically, it is like a U-shaped manufacturing process in which there is minimum time wastage. Okay. So the process flows in a U-shaped. Then there is process innovation and business process re-engineering. BPR is business process re-engineering. So this process innovation and BPR, they are concerned with processes, innovating processes or redesigning the processes, which will lead to less wastage and more profits for the organization. So these are the different topics under lean system, which you need to study. So I hope you liked the video. I have tried to cover the topics in as much detail and is as much depth as possible. So basically मेरा objective यही है कि आप self preparation कर पाएं. मैंने आपको जो टॉपिक्स डिटेल में बता दिए हैं तो अब आप गूगल करके या टेक्स्ट बुक से भी पढ़ के अपनी प्रिपरेशन कर सकते हैं. सो ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स, आई विल कम अप विद सिमिलर वीडियोस ऑन अदर टॉपिक्स आल्सो. सो स्टे ट्यून्ड टू आवर चैनल. हैव अ नाइस डे.